Hi all. In this video, let's learn about some of the interesting points regarding the JavaScript and HTML. So let's start with the first one. We know how to split a string. So this is how we do. So I have taken one string and we know how to split this string with the comma separated. So now let's see what would be the output. So when you do a comma separated, then you will be getting like this. So apple and banana cherries in two arrays. This is how we get when you use a split operator with one comma separated. What if I wanted to use multiple separators? Like I want to separate the string with comma and semicolon as well. So for that, you need to use a split operator in a different way. Let me show you that. So I will take another one, multi separator, and I will use a list dot split. And here you need to use an array. So first one would be comma separated and second one is semicolon. So we need to do in this way. And we need to keep the backslashes before and after to escape this array. So this is how we need to use. Here you can keep a number of separators as per your requirement. So let me write a console to show you. So usually when I write this split and one semicolon, the return value would be an array by having two values. One is apple and one is banana and cherries. Now, as we have given two separators, we'll be getting three array values, apples, bananas, and cherries. Let me show you that. So I have console that you can now see. This is a normal split with the comma separated. This is multiple separator. So now you have multiple split. Now the string was splitted into two ways with the comma and the semicolon as well. So this is how you need to do the multi-separator with the split operator. So let's go to the second point. Let me show you the second point is regarding the lazy loading of an image. So usually in the HTML, this is not related to any design pattern or any dependency we are using here. We are using plain HTML to load the images lazily. So let's see that. So these two images we have loaded on spot because these images are in the viewport. It means whatever you are seeing on the screen, we should not make the users for wait, which not wait the users. So here the loading attribute, what does this loading attribute is? This will tell the browser how should the image should download. If you mention the loading symbol and if you give an value like this eager, so it will download the image immediately. So whereas if you say lazy, it will download the image once the page was finished downloading and parsing. Only after that it will take this image and it will download them. So when to use this loading lazy is when the images are not in the viewport. What does the viewport means? If user, whatever user sees, that is a viewable part, visible in the viewport. Whatever user can't see, it means when you scroll the image. So let me show you with an example. So I will show that with an example. So whatever I see here, I may get two images at once. So whenever I scroll them, I need to see more images. Then only these images will come into the viewport. We can download these images later. So that's the reason the images which are visible in the viewport, those should be loaded eagerly. So it means it should be loaded as on when immediately. Whereas coming to the images which are not on the viewport, device viewport, they can be given with this diff attribute. So let me show you this in the network. So once I click this, so here you can see the waterfall. So first two images are loaded immediately, but the next images there are loaded after the page was loaded finishing. After the page was downloaded, entire page was downloaded and parsed, then all these images are started downloading. So this is how you can use the loading lazy property to load your images lazily. We don't need any of the dependencies to load the images. So this is all about the second point. So coming to the third point, if you want to refresh your page or if you want to redirect your page to some other website after a certain amount of time, then no need to use JavaScript. We have an HTML tag, that is meta tag. So with this meta tag, you can able to do this. So I will use HTTP, this HTTP EQIV attribute, and you need to give the property as refresh. And also you need to mention the timeout. So if you mention 5, so it means it takes 5 seconds to close. It will refresh for every 5 seconds, this page would be refreshed. So let me check this. So for every 5 seconds, this page would be refreshed. Okay, let me see that. 1, 2, 3, yep, it was refreshed. If you observe, there is an loading icon we'll be getting here on the top. So see, for every 5 seconds, it would be refreshed. So if you want to refresh your page for every 5 seconds, you can use the format in this way. What if you want to redirect your page after certain amount to some other URL? So then you need to mention here the URL. So I want to redirect the page to some other website after 5 seconds. So then I will be writing here. So let me give my own YouTube channel link. So after 5 seconds, I am trying to this will be redirected to this another website. So here you can give whatever website you want. After 5 seconds, it would be redirected to this page. So let's see that. I think you need to mention HTTPS here. So let's see that. Yep. I think something. So after 5 seconds, we'll be redirected to the YouTube channel. You can see here, after 5 seconds, we have redirected to the another website. So in this way, you can redirect your websites to the another page, or you can refresh the same page only with the content and 5 attribute. So for now, I'm commenting out this because it will refresh for every 5 seconds. So this is all about the third point, how to redirect to other pages with only the HTML tag, meta tag, and the HTML env refresh property and content timeout. So these are the things we need to use to refresh the page or redirect the page. So coming to the fourth point. So how to remove the falsy values in an array. So we have 1, 2, what are the falsy values here? So empty string is a falsy value, false value, undefined, nan, and 0. All these are the falsy values. If you want to remove the falsy values from an array, the easiest way is, let me show you, I will write a console and just I will print it. Array dot, just use a filter operator to the array and mention the value as Boolean. If you mention this Boolean, all the falsy values in this array would be removed and you will be getting an array without the falsy values. Let me show you that. So I need to go back. So this HTTP was appended because we have used that HTTP meta tag. So usually, yeah, now in this console, you can see all the falsy values are removed and we could able to see only the truth values. So this is the easiest way to remove the falsy values in an array. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.